We have a consumer alert tonight. Millions of Americans shopping for holiday gifts are competing for the best deals, but it may not be a fair fight.
Retail experts say a large share of online buying is being done by automated bots, software designed to scoop up huge amounts of popular items and resell them at higher prices. As Mark Strassman reports, the problem has grown worse since the pandemic began.
Take Sony's PS5 gaming console, a hot item in this second COVID Christmas. About $500 retail, but good luck. No store seems to have one. Ask Dave Kennedy, a father of two teenage boys.
I've been on Marketplace and even on eBay and that, and the astronomical.
How much?
The lowest I think I've seen is about $950. You know, it's frustrating. Absolutely frustrating. You know, there's kids that want it, and there's adults buying these things to resell them.
Think of shoppers shoving each other aside in stores. Online, that stampede is invisible. Grinch bots, automated software, relentlessly searching, finding, snapping up hot consumer items in nanoseconds before you can.
It's not illegal, but it's certainly unethical.
So not black market, but gray market.
Gray market, for sure.
We met Pam Murphy, the CEO of Imperva, a cybersecurity company, at their headquarters outside of San Francisco.
Here we've got an example of a bad bot trying to get through.
Imperva's customers include major retailers. They face a perfect Grinchbot storm, the pandemic, a surge in online shopping, and America's supply chain crisis.
They basically go onto retail sites and they basically scan the inventory at a rate often of more than once per second, and they effectively buy it up before the average consumer can.
And during the pandemic, bot activity on retail sites doubled. That's why online you're seeing more of this CAPTCHA command. It's a bot blocker.
Nobody gets all of them, right?
You're right, it can never be 100%.
Last Christmas, the PS5 was new. Bot traffic surged 800%.
You feel a certain amount of pressure to deliver.
Absolutely. And it's a letdown for them when you can't, right?
He knows the underground economy he's up against. No ifs, ands, or buts. Mark Strassman, San Francisco.